You're now tuned into the Lady Charmaine Live Show, and I'm your host, Lady Charmaine. And as always, I have another great interview for you today. When you think of social justice, hashtag cut 50, be woke and vote, this person just might come to mind. And I tell you who it is coming up right after this. Guest today is a political commentator, New York Times bestseller, and in 2004 he was recognized as a young global leader. He was ranked one of the 12 most creative minds in 2008, and in 2009 Time magazine named him one of the 100 most influential people in the world. And he is here today to talk about his new CNN show, The Redemption Project, airing Sunday, April the 28th. Help me welcome to the Lady Charmaine Live Show, Mr. Van Jones. Welcome to the show.
Hey, I'm glad to be here.
Well, I am so glad that you are here, Van. And, you know, you are so interesting because, you know, I watch you on TV, and then when I got the request, I'm like, absolutely. But I want to talk to you about the Redemption Project in just a moment because it was so powerful that I really can't even bring it into words because it had me literally crying. I was because if people, you have to watch the show to get what I'm saying, and you really have to be in a space because it's going to bring up literally memories and emotions for people that may have been in this situation. And so we're definitely going to talk about that and why you decided to do something like this. But I want people to know a little bit about your background because I read that both of your parents were educators. Your mother was a teacher and your father was also a school principal. But this was one of the things I thought was interesting when your sister, I read something that your sister said that you were a stereotypical geek. So how would you describe yourself growing up?
Yeah, absolutely. I made Urkel look cool when I was growing up. And I think that there are a lot of people like that, you know, maybe not the most popular kid in high school, maybe not the most athletic, but when you grow up that way and you aren't a part of the in crowd and you're a magnet for bullies, once you grow up, you have so much more empathy for people who are left out and people who don't have, you know, that inside track. And so, you know, I grew up and, you know, 6'1" and, you know, all that kind of stuff. And I'm able to go to law school and I've done a lot of things, but I've never lost that empathy and that sympathy for the underdog.
So how did you go into social justice? Where did that passion come from?
Well, you know, I was an African-American young person in the early 90s. You know, I was in law school, and I got out in 93 and 92. You had the Rodney King uprising after four police officers were acquitted in their beating of a black motorist on videotape. At the time, that was unheard of, just to have a videotape of, you know, caught in the act. You know, very shortly after that, the Clinton crime bill passed, and they started building prisons everywhere. And as a young African-American man, I kind of felt like my generation was under the gun. And even though I would never got in any trouble myself, I thought, here I am, I'm 24 years old, I got a law degree from Yale, let me do something to help the community. And 25 years later, I'm still at it.
Yeah, because, I mean, you have an amazing story. You have, I mean, such accolades as I read earlier. And then you also did work in the San Francisco Bay Area where I'm from. And at the time, I didn't even know who you were. But now I do know and I see the work that you've done. And I read about how the Rodney King verdict affected your life and the trajectory of your career. So now here we are. You've hosted several shows like Crossfire, The Van Jones Show, The Messy Truth, Be Woke and Vote. And now you have a powerful show on TV that I believe is going to touch so many lives. It's regarding grace and forgiveness. And when I watched the screener, there's a gentleman on there that I know who is an Oakland activist. I do not want to give it away. And I cried because I know who he is and to feel that emotion. My husband and I both were. We both watched it together. And I want to know, why did you decide to do a show like this, The Brainchild? How did this even come up? Because to be able to face a person that took your loved one's life and to look at them face to face and have a conversation, that takes a lot. Whose idea was this?
Well, you know, it's an idea I came up with. You know, we have an Oscar nominated director, Jason Cohen. He had a film where he showed reconciliation between a former U.S. neo-Nazi and one of his victims of violence. And I said, you know, we really need to do something. And I don't want people to think this is a downer of a show. It's heartbreaking, but it's a very healing show. What we do is we have 8 episodes, and we talk to 8 people who have done stuff that's really bad and who want to make amends 10 years later, 20 years later. And then we talk to the person that they hurt, or all too often the surviving family member. Mm-hmm. And then we film them for the first time sitting down face to face and talking to each other. And it is an extraordinary experience to be a part of and to bring to television. In 2 out of the 8 episodes, the surviving parents did not, have a warm and fuzzy feeling toward the person who hurt their child. However, they did get healing because they finally got some questions answered. They finally got some information that they had not been able to get through the courts and anything else. Mm-hmm. So it helped them. But 3 out of the 8 got to the point where they actually went and successfully got the person out of prison. And so you literally have the whole range of experience. And what we wanted to do, I feel like our culture has just gotten anti-forgiveness. The culture, it's all about call-out culture and cancel culture, and I'm going to block you, and it's just gotten worse and worse. And I wanted to have a show that went 180 degrees in the other direction. Empathy is not trendy right now. Mm-hmm. Redemption, forgiveness, second chances, listening, trying, healing, it's not trendy. And I said, let's go 180 degrees against the trend and put something on TV that can be heartbreaking, but also very, very healing and profound. And I hope people give it a chance.
And it takes you on a journey, because the Oakland activist I'm talking about, many may know who are from the Bay Area, they'll watch the show and listen to the show. It's Donald Lacey. And it took me on an emotional roller coaster, because to see how he was preparing for the person that murdered his daughter. But one of the big things was when the gentleman who murdered his daughter walked in the room, his reaction. I was not expecting his reaction when he walked in the room and looked at
Well, let's not give it away now.
Giving it away. I just want people to see. I'm not going to tell what the reaction was, because people don't know if he got mad and was fighting. But the reaction, and because I know I have my own personal experience that's not too long ago. So, but, you know, for me to be able to face the individuals, it takes a lot. And it's literally forgiveness.
It sure does.
But I want to let everybody know it's God. So for those who are watching the show, you can't do it in your own strength. It has to be the Lord is going to take you through this, because this is dealing with forgiveness and it's dealing with grace. And I want to say thank you so much for bringing this show to us, because we need to look at ourselves. Are we able to forgive? And I think that's like the ultimate forgiveness. That's the ultimate.
Well, I tell you. Yeah, well, I tell you, you know, people say, is this a true crime show? Mm-hmm. And I say, no, you know, true crime is kind of like a whodunit. Mm-hmm. We already know who done it in these shows. This is about the truth years after the crime, when there's still no healing, when people are still stuck, when people still have not gotten their questions answered, because, you know, you can go through a trial and still never get the truth. Yep. Or sometimes people just plead guilty and take a plea and go away, and you still do not know what happened. And, or why it happened. And so it's a healing journey that everybody involved goes through. Like I said, it doesn't always wind up warm and fuzzy, but sometimes it winds up miraculous. And you will see, I would say 8 or 9 times out of 10, on both sides of the table, grace is grounded in faith. Mm-hmm. We've gotten so secular as a culture that a lot of times on cable television, you don't even hear the word God. Mm-mm. And yet in this series, again, to get through what these folks have gone through and to come out the other side, a lot of them turn to faith and speak on their faith. And we make sure that that didn't get cut out, because we want people to know we have an awful lot of data. Mm-hmm. We have very little wisdom in our culture at this point. More data than ever, less wisdom than ever. And those wisdom traditions, those spiritual traditions, those religious traditions, I believe can be a source of us bringing us back to our best selves.
Absolutely. And Van, again, I want to say thank you so much for coming on the show. And I want to remind the audience to make sure that you tune in Sunday, April the 28th, 9 p.m. Eastern Central for the Redemption Project. Make sure you have a box of tissues next to you when you watch this series for the next 8 weeks. It is that powerful. And again, thank you so much, Van. I appreciate you coming on the show and I look forward to having you back.
Thank you very much. You know, we're very proud of CNN that we get a chance to do stuff like this, and I hope that everybody will tune in.
Absolutely. Again, thank you so much. And again, that was Mr. Van Jones. Be sure to tune in this Sunday, April the 28th, for the Redemption Project. It's going to be airing right there on CNN. It's going to be 9 p.m. Eastern Pacific. Make sure you grab some friends. If you've been through any type of situation where a loved one was taken from you, you need to be in front of the television watching this show. And again, thank you to my guest today, Mr. Van Jones.
Thank you.